Hello students, welcome to the session. Now we will study about AC equivalent circuit from the paper 6, physics paper 6 of unit 3, that is analog electronics. So from analog electronics, from analog electronics unit 3, we are going to study about AC equivalent circuit, which is a continued part of the earlier class DC equivalent circuit. So in this AC equivalent circuit, once again consider this original circuit, CE amplifier circuit containing voltage divider bias and an AC source and a DC source plus VCC and ground here, transistor and coupling capacitor 1, output coupling capacitor and a bypass capacitor. So in this original CE amplifier circuit, in the last class we studied how DC equivalent circuit is obtained, and today let us see how AC equivalent circuit is obtained. So after obtaining AC equivalent circuit, this is how the circuit looks like. So in order to get an AC equivalent circuit, let us see what are the conditions. As I already told, in AC equivalent circuit only AC conditions are considered. That means the DC voltages must be considered as zero, just like the DC equivalent circuit where all the ACs are considered as zero. Now here in DC equivalent circuit, we should consider DC voltage must be equal to zero. Thus the capacitors are selected to be large enough to appear as short to the signal. Hence in an AC equivalent circuit, we must consider these two conditions. They are, first of all DC sources are treated as shorts. All DC sources are treated as shorts and all capacitors are treated as shorts. So in order to get AC equivalent circuit, consider all the DC sources treated as shorts and all the capacitors treated as shorts. So in this circuit, consider the DC supply plus VCC as short. That means connect this directly to the ground, short it, connect the positive end of the power supply to the negative, so it becomes a short circuit, and all the capacitors are treated as shorts. So when the value is very high, the capacitors must be selected large enough to appear as shorts. So the capacitors are treated as shorts now, and the DC source is shorted. So what we left with is the source, AC source V in, and when this end of plus VCC is shorted, what happens is the upper end of RB1 is connected to ground and lower end of RB2 is connected to ground. Like this, AC source and one end of R1 is connected to ground, which was earlier connected to the power source. Now it is connected to ground because power source is treated as short, and R2 is grounded, and then emitter is grounded. From the collector, this RC resistor's upper end is actually connected to plus VCC, but in the AC equivalent circuit it is treated as short. Therefore that is connected to the ground here. So RC also connected to the ground. And next one is RL. From the collector, R upper end of RL is connected to R collector and the lower end is connected to ground. So in the AC equivalent circuit, after considering those two points, treating DC source as short and treating capacitors as short, we left with only this thing. So no capacitor is present here and no DC source is present here, only the resistors R1, R2, RC and RL with the transistor which is amplifying. Now using AC equivalent circuit, circuit voltages and currents are calculated. And also note that the plus VCC, which indicate positive terminal of the DC supply and the negative of which is grounded, positive and negative are shorted. So R1 and RC also grounded. Hence plus VCC ends of R1, RE become AC ground points. So plus VCC is grounded. That's why plus VCC ends of R1 and RE becomes AC ground points. So in this slide, see that the total current in any branch is the sum of DC and AC current through that branch. So in order to calculate the current or voltage in any branch, what we have to do is calculate the DC component and AC component separately after taking the equivalent circuit. Calculate separately. So this is the original circuit which is biased with the positive DCC supply. So positive power supply is here and this is a biased circuit and this is the DC equivalent circuit. And last one is a AC equivalent circuit. See, R1 and R2 are parallel, so it is written together. Otherwise R1 will be here, R2 will be here, and this is the equivalent resistance R1 parallel to R2, and then transistor and RC, then RL. So RC is equal to RC parallel to RL, it is written together. And this is the short form of the AC equivalent circuit. So similarly, total voltage across any branch is the sum of DC and AC voltages across that branch. So across any branch, the sum of the voltage is the voltage is the sum of DC and AC across that branch. So this is all about AC and DC equivalent circuit. Thank you.